You look pale. You swear off red meat?
You don't have to do this.
What do you suggest? I wait for what?
Well, there has to be another way.
You're worried, huh? I'm touched. I'm curious, man.
You don't know what you're getting yourself into, though.
It's a very simple conversation I have to have with your friend, Scully. Very simple. I may not get another opportunity to do it. And that is that me and my club have nothing to do with his dealings with you.
All right. I'm just saying, don't do anything that you don't have to do.
My intention is not to do anything I don't have to do. It's a simple little conversation we're going to have. And in my inimitable snake oil way, I will convince him that the way things are is the way things need to be. And that'll be it. And I'll leave there as peacefully as I went in.
Is that where you're packing?
Also, I'm not a fool. Yeah, come in.
Oh, sorry to interrupt.
That's all right. I'm on my way out. Come on in. What's up?
It's a liquor delivery. It's square. I already checked it out. This is the invoice.
Okay, put it on the desk, will you?
Sure.
Hey. Hold down a fort, you two. I'll be back in two shakes.
See that you are.
Something wrong?
Hope not.
Fowley's gumshoe still outside?
Yeah. They're standing around an ash can fire, keeping warm.
Such ingenuity.
They look like they're freezing their tails off.
Good, good. And as soon as Spencer shows up, they'll run till Donnelly. And the good commissioner will be on the premises in the New York Minute. Right where we want him.
What you do is you rub it back, and then you let it go, and it goes on its own. Give me five. Come on, man. Cool. Anyway, so, I mean, I'm glad to be at Ruby's, but, I miss my mom.
I can't blame you, baby.
But, you know, Dad and Sonny are going to have it all fixed real soon.
Oh, cool.
I hope so.
Yeah, I mean, when Dad says he's going to get something done, he does it, you know? I mean, he doesn't want Mom and Leslie Lou out of town one more minute than they have to be.
Oh, cool.
No, I'm not under kid.
Well, it's definitely not strep. I just got the official word from the lab.
Oh, thank goodness. I'm thinking that it might be an ear infection because he's got a temperature that's up around 100. So I phoned in a prescription for an antibiotic. Cora's going to go pick it up in a few minutes.
Oh, thank you.
Well, how's he acting? Like he wants to come down and play.
Oh, well, then that's a good sign.
But I told young Raphael that we've all got to go home, which we do, so we might as well go to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
Tommy, where's your coat?
I don't know. Oh, I'll get it.
Oh, thanks, Lucy.
Here, well.
I'm going to go warm up the car. I'll be right back.
Okay, babe. Thanks.
Watch this. I can just... Hey, guys, it's cleanup time, all right?
Uh-huh.
Cool. There's probably some under the chair. Actually, Buster and I are going, too.
But everybody's leaving me.
I have homework. I'm sorry.
That's the weekend.
You think they'd let me rest? Besides, I mean, I need to be back home because my dad wants me at Ruby's.
That's where you better be.
Okay.
Thanks for helping out.
Oh, are you kidding me? I wouldn't miss it. Give me five, guys. Awesome. Come on.
I was told to find Grand Central Station here.
You got that right. Hi, Lily.
Oh,
no. How you doing?
Wow. Good. Hola, Lucky. ¿Cómo estás?
Muy bien, gracias. Tengo marcharme ahora. Mucho, homework.
The word for homework is tarea.
Gracias.
De nada.
Miss Rivera is a Spanish teacher in school, and Sly and me are taking classes.
I'm very impressed. And good luck on your homework.
Okay, Foster. You're out of here, buddy.
No one leave. It is cold out there.
I'm sorry. Richie, come on. Let's go upstairs, huh?
Not you too, Tommy. Well, I guess I better get you buttoned up. Where's your mother?
She's out warming up the car.
Let me get out of the way.
Oh, no, you're not in the way. Girl, this is normal. Here, Tommy.
Calmer than normal, if you ask me.
This is about as good as it gets. Now, what did you want to say?
Hey, well, we're out of here. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Now, what is it, Lily?
There's something I'd like to discuss with you when you have the chance.
I'm all ears.
It's dead.
Thank you.
I just had that battery replaced.
Well, it could be a starter or a frozen fuel line. Anyway, it's too cold to worry about it now. I'll give you a ride home.
But you just got here.
And I know how to get back. Besides, there's some foundation questions I'd like to run by you. You know, about the clinic.
Okay. That'd be nice.
All right.
I'm hot.
Oh, I know, sweetheart. We're leaving soon.
I think you should call the tow truck first. Leave your keys with me, and you can pick up your car in the morning.
That's a great idea. One more minute, Tommy. Sorry, Cora. I'll call from home. Here. Thank you, Maymay.
I hope it's nothing serious. Have you heard from Tom lately?
No. I was expecting him day before yesterday. I'm used to last-minute changes of plans. I'm sure he's fine. Okay, Tommy, here we go.
Granny Mae, I'll talk to you later.
Bye. Drive safely.
Oh, precious cargo.
How do you do it?
I have no choice. It's just us. Go ahead.
Well, believe it or not, I want to ask if I may join in.
Well, I like what I'm hearing, but you're not making fun.
Oh, no, never. I would love to volunteer at the Bradley Ward House, let's say 2 afternoons a week.
You mean regular?
If you'll have me.
If I'll have you, girl! When can you start?
Right away.
Oh, my goodness, no further discussion from me. Anyone who can work with children all day and then take them on after that, they either got to be crazy or Mother Teresa.
Well, you do it. Besides, right at the moment, there's nothing I want more in my life than children.
And why might that be, if I may ask?
Well, 6 years ago, I had a child of my own that my father forced me to give him away. I just recently saw him in Puerto Rico, where he is living happily with his adoptive parents, whom I love dearly, and will contact us if he wants to when he gets older.
Contact us?
Juan's father is Miguel.
Oh, my.
Yes. So, we are sharing the loss of not having watched our son grow up. Mm-hmm. But we are very lucky because we have each other. And we can help each other through missing him. We've done everything we can for him, and we have let go. But there's still that something that draws me to children.
Everyone in the world can understand that.
Thank you.
No, thank you. I think what you're doing is a very constructive and beneficial thing with that experience. And I feel that your working here will help fill some of those empty feelings that you have. It's helped me.
It's already begun.
Then it looks like we're in business. Boy, that's the easiest recruiting job I've ever done. Oh, my. And I know the children are going to love you.
Oh, if I could only give them a little something, it would make me feel so much better.
Oh.
There's nothing as painful as being separated from your own child. Even if it's one you never really had the chance to know.
Luke is walking into major trouble because of my partnership with him. I don't like doing that to him.
Is there anything I can do to help?
Do me a favor.
Anything.
Forget I mentioned it.
Wait a second.
What?
Just take it easy. Look, I'm not trying to crowd you. I like this gig and I like Luke, but the main point of my being here is you.
Oh, come on. I don't have time.
Of course you do. You got 30 seconds for your old man. Look, 30 years of neglect and stupidity to the contrary, I still give a damn what happens to you. I don't want to see you get blown away, okay? Sue me.
Break my heart.
Look, this is no sob story, kid. All I'm saying is that if there's trouble, I want to help.
That would be a first, wouldn't it?
Well, given our history, I'd say that was a fair shot.
Not even close.
All right. I blew it with you.
Yeah.
I was a lousy father, okay? But maybe I'm trying to make up for lost time.
Lost time? You think all you have to do was make up for is lost time? Let me tell you what was lost, Pop. It wasn't just time, it was a life. Two lives, my mother's and mine. How old was she when you split? She was a kid, with a kid. Anybody to help her? No!
I know.
No, you don't know. You don't know what kind of crap you put her through. She didn't tell you because she was too kind to make you feel guilty. Collecting soda cans for deposits, working double shifts, leaving me with so-called friends. And every time you would come at the door, she'd throw it open and welcome you home. Still hoping, still dreaming you'd stay. And then you'd take some of her money, drink some of her hooch, have a quick row in the hay, and then you'd split again. Years I spent making up for you being gone. And now you're gonna tell me all you gotta do is make up for his lost time?
Look, I know I can't make right the wrongs that I did, but your mother's gone. But you and I are still left on this earth together.
Since when does being on the same planet mean anything to you?
All right, stop. Look, I know what I did, and I'm not proud of it. I was young and I was stupid. What I'm asking for is another chance.
And I'm telling you, you've had all the chances a person gets in a lifetime. What do you want from me? Forgiveness? You think I could just wipe out all the memories? You don't think I don't recognize another con from Mike Corbin? No way, old man. Took the hike.
Huh? And Mrs. Ward has the keys. All right, Ben. Thank you very much. Terrific. Bye. I'll pick the car up tonight, and maybe I'll have it by tomorrow.
Oh, well, great.
That's easy to say until they figure out what's wrong with it.
True. But it's not ready. You just give me a call, and Johnny on the spot, I will play chauffeur tomorrow.
Yeah, like you really have time for that.
Please, I'll make time.
You know, I've got a big chicken pot pie in the freezer. Why don't you stay for dinner?
Well,
Yes, stay.
All right, you talked me into it. I'll stay. Thank you.
Great. I'll just go get dinner started. Tommy, why don't you take care of Justice for a few minutes?
What do you like to play?
Well, mister, you name it and I play. What do you got?
I know. Just wait.
Luke, how are you this evening? Please, have a seat. I offer you a glass of the house red. It's excellent.
I'm not here to drink with you, Scully.
Yes, sir. Spencer just arrived at the No Name Supper Club. He's having a sit-down with Joe Scully. He wanted to know.
All right, thanks. I'm on my way.
Are you going to sit down? Or make me strain my neck? What's the matter? Don't you feel we should be sharing the same table?
The jury's still out.
Well, you're thinking we don't have much in common. On the surface, I will agree with you. For instance, I have good manners, you don't.
Is that right?
Well, the scene over at your place the other day was entirely unnecessary. Very rude behavior on your part.
Oh, sensitive, aren't you?
And as a matter of fact, I'm very sensitive.
Well, that was just straight talk. I thought it was important that we understand each other.
We didn't. Not by a long shot. That's why we're here today. To understand the one thing we have in common.
And what would that be?
Sonny. We both call him friend. We both have his best interests at heart. Am I right in this?
As long as his best interests coincide with my best interests.
Shall I him out so soon?
Sonny has to decide what's important to him.
Well, that's why I believe our Sonny is treading on thin ice. I think, in a way, he's way over his head in many areas. I don't know if you're aware of the extent of his ambition, but unfortunately, he doesn't have the experience or the strength or the stomach for the life he's chosen. He's soft. He's going to get himself killed. I don't want to see that happen. I don't think you do either.
Look, I don't want to see a lot of things happen. But I try to concentrate on what I have some kind of control over. This is Sonny's life and Sonny's business. I just don't like it when his life or business brings a whole lot of stuff my way from people like you.
I'm here to prevent trouble, Spencer.
Really? By sticking me in between you and the cops? Or by sticking Sonny in between me and whatever muscle you send in to take care of me? I don't think so. Now, I'm going to buy him out of that club. I'm just about to the point of doing that. And if I do that, then whatever he does with you, he does. Because I'm out of it.
That's another thing we don't have in common. You're naive. You think you can walk away from this? Just walk out, clean as a whistle, knowing what you know.
You want to run that past me again? I thought I heard maybe a little threat in there.
Well, you guys must be freezing out here.
Listen, we've passed freezing a long time. Spencer went in 10 minutes ago. So far, it's quiet.
Let's hope it stays that way. Sometimes quiet's no good. Maybe we should go inside.
Oh, no.
Garcia, it's a members-only club. All we do is send everybody home early and bring up the party. Let's cover all the exits and wait.
Right. Dickinson, you take the front door. McKeon, take the back.
No. You take the side. I'll take the back.
You sure about that, boss? We're calling for a car. Should be here soon.
Garcia, all we're doing is listening. But when Spencer comes out, under no circumstances do we let him leave until I find out what the hell went down in there. All right, let's do it.
With yourself. What have you been up to this evening?
Well, I just got back from the Bradley Ward House. I'm going to be working there 2 afternoons a week.
With children, Millie, that's great.
I'm so excited. I love the place. And I love her.
I love her also. Come on, you tell me right now. Tell me everything. What are you going to be doing? After school? I guess so. You won't be tired, right? And are you going to be teaching or just... What is it... Be like, why are you staring at me like this?
I don't want to wait, Miguel.
I don't understand. Wait for what?
To be married. Make love to me. Now. Tonight. This minute. Be confused about. I know you love me. We're going to be married and we want each other.
Hey, baby. Don't get me wrong. When I lay at night in this bed, all I can think about is you. Being here with you. But when we make love, I think it should be for the right reasons, Lily.
The right reasons?
Yes.
What more do we need? What else could there be? We love each other. We've wasted so much time already.
But you convinced me we should wait. And I agree. What made you change your mind?
You changed it. You convinced me that there's no reason to wait. I was wrong and you were right. Miguel, I want to spend the rest of my life with you. And I wanted to start now. What?
I think I know what's going on.
Okay. Dinner's on its way.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Not bad.
Where's Tommy?
Oh, he is in search of a toy for us to play with.
Uh-oh.
What, am I in trouble? Is some big mechanized monster going to come rumbling through this room?
You never know.
Well, if it does, I'm prepared.
Will be.
Oh. You don't mind my saying so. You look a little tired.
Tired? What's that? There's no place for tired in my world. No time for it.
Everyone's entitled.
I have too much to do to be tired.
Well, you do seem to do quite a bit. But I guess raising a son all by yourself takes an enormous amount of energy.
In a word, yes. It does.
It's a brilliant observation on my part.
Remember the 80s, Mom? She had a kid, maybe two, had an office job, did the shopping, the cooking, the cleaning, and still had energy and time left for her man when he came home?
Oh, yeah.
Remember that magazine cover? This woman in running shoes, jogging with her kid in a power stroller, carrying a bag of groceries, with the briefcase.
And a big old smile on her face the whole time. I remember. I remember.
Oh, we expected an awful lot of ourselves. I remember thinking, girl, that is one foolish choice. And now I realize that I really don't have a choice. I have to do it all.
Including being a father.
Not too. As best I can.
And it's really okay with you that you haven't heard from Tom.
Tom's on his way. I know he left Africa. I know he's not here. I can't deal with what I don't know. Maybe he's stuck in a layover in Europe or something.
Well, it's got to be hard on him.
Oh, layovers are awful.
No, I mean, being split between two worlds the way he is. Head in Africa and his heart here.
We manage. You know, it's hard on me, too.
No doubt.
And on Tommy. Lately, I've been wondering, you know, is this really fair to him?
I think it's probably a little bit unfair to all three of you.
Well, up until now, it seemed to work fine. But I don't know if it's my energy level or Tommy getting older or maybe the whole thing's just wearing thin, but... Oh, I think the simplest way to put it is Tommy needs a father. And to answer your question, no. I can't be both. Oh, and I'm starting to wonder if I really should be holding on to something which in at least one fundamental way isn't working. Sorry. I didn't mean to lay that on you.
Oh, please, don't you dare apologize. I mean, you're talking about holding on to your marriage.
Something's got to change. Ooh, hate that word a lot.
Yeah, change is scary.
Or exhilarating.
Well, see, I like your attitude.
There you are. I wondered what happened to you.
Here, he's for you.
Oh, okay.
Purple guy's my favorite.
Fair enough. Fair enough. To be continued. Okay, now, Tommy, what do you call these guys, anyway?
These are the Power Strangers. Come on, let's play.
All righty. Here we go. Power Stranger number one, come in.
You underestimate me, Luke. I don't threaten people. I state facts. I can say with certainty from years of experience that people with knowledge such as yours do not simply walk away.
What knowledge? I know nothing about you. I know nothing about your operation.
Well, you know enough to have formed an opinion about me. A very low opinion.
That's based solely on limited personal experience and public record.
All right. For the sake of argument, that's all you know. But you're connected in this town. You could pick up the phone, bring heat down on me or my organization or Sonny. Normally, this situation, together with your bad attitude, would have me making plans to eliminate that possibility. However, Sonny says you've gone on a life run, plus your partners. So I'm inclined to try to work out a deal. Can we find a way to cooperate?
Cooperate? How?
You manage your club. Keep your nose out of my business with Sonny. Offer me, say, 10% of your operation. To guarantee that no unpleasantness will be directed towards you or your family. And I think we can coexist peacefully.
Protection, Scully. I told you I don't pay protection. It's also an ultimatum and you can stuff it. You got one choice here. You deal with Sonny directly and leave me out of it. No arrangements, no deals.
I'm genuinely baffled. Why do you persist in this hostility towards me? It's almost stupid. I mean, you dealt with Frank for years. Didn't you learn anything about respect?
It's not the same situation at all. First of all, I got no beef with you. And unless you just fabricate something, you got no beef with me. And secondly, I knew Frank a long, long time, Scully. You're no Frank Smith. Now look, I don't pay protection. That's it, and I sure as hell ain't coming to work for you. So you just get your business out of my business. Leave me and my club alone.
So tight, he'll snap if someone sneezes. You know what to do, Jim.
Right.
Kick, kick.
Evasive action, circling.
Shot, spin.
Ah, combinations, but not good enough. Ah, oh. But I shall return to rule the world! You know, when I was his age, I would not have known what to make of a toy like this. Means I'm an old man, huh, Tommy? Power of Strangers. I guess it's just a sign of the times. Here you have this ordinary, young, high school kid. Nobody thinks twice about him. But inside this ordinary young man are these hidden powers. And when times get tough, he turns into this lean, mean machine who can chase the bad guys away. Now, it strikes me that we can all be like that, you know, because inside of each one of us are a lot of hidden strengths, right? Even though we might not know that they're there, all we have to do is allow ourselves to be willing to change.
Yeah.
See? You know what, Tommy? This has been a lot of fun. But do you have some regular toys, you know, that an old man like me can relate to? Like marbles?
Sure. We're back.
All right.
some riff on the Power Strangers.
I don't even know where it came from. Hmm. Here I thought these guys were just an excuse for violence and mayhem.
Just a moment of insight, I guess.
May I share an insight with you?
Please.
Okay, don't be mad, Lily. I'm just gonna let you know what I feel and what I see, okay? You say you went to Mary May's house this afternoon. What were you really doing there?
What I told you. Volunteering to work with children.
Did you by any chance tell her about Juan?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I did. He's part of the reason that working there seems so right.
Could it be that he's part of the reason why making love seems so right? Could it be that you miss him that much?
Of course I miss him. I miss him every day.
Okay. Okay, Lily, well, I think that whenever we make love, it should be about us and about the love that we have for each other, not about the son we lost.
How could you say such a thing?
I'm just telling you what I see, Lily. Are you trying to replace him?
No.
Okay. We saw him recently. You have him in your thoughts. You're surrounding yourself with children whenever you can. And I think that's beautiful. But I don't think it's fair for us to bring a child into this world right now, at this moment, and ask him to be a replacement for one.
Once we're married, you won't want children?
Of course not. Lily, no. Wait. You know how much I want a family with you. All I'm saying is that our children should be born into a marriage. If we learned anything, we've learned that. God, Lily, I want lots of kids. But I want them to be born when the time is right. I want them to be part of a healthy structure. I want them to be safe, Lily. That's all I want.
I want that, too. But, Miguel, what does that have to do with making love to me now? We're going to be married.
Okay, but I think that what you have in your mind right now is the loss of Juan. And missing Juan should be completely different from us making love and our marriage. You understand?
Do you really think once we're married, I'm going to stop missing Juan? Miguel, I will always miss him.
So will I.
Then how will we know when the time is right to have another child?
We'll know.
When our motives are separate from Juan?
We'll know, Lily. I'm sure. You're taking this much harder than I meant. All I'm trying to do is protect you from doing something too soon, Lily, or maybe for the wrong reasons. You...
Really?
Yes.
Why does it feel like rejection?
You know it's not, Lily. I love you.
I think I should go.
No, you, please.
The mood is broken now, isn't it? And you've given me lots to think about.
I've insulted you. I'm so sorry, Lily.
So am I. Don't worry. I'll be fine.
Dump them out, and then can you get your thumb behind it like that?
Sorta.
Okay, now give it a shot.
Hey. I hit them.
Yes, you did. And see, that's the idea, is to knock all of them out of the circle and make this into a circle. Now, see, if this was on the sidewalk, we draw this in chalk, but on the rug, we do it with some string. Now, the idea, to blast as many of them as you can out of the circle. Now, check this out. Hey.
All right.
Yeah. Excellent. See, now it's amazing how you never lose the touch. Okay. Now, if this was a real tough neighborhood, then I would get to keep all those marbles that I knocked out. That's where the saying, all the marbles, comes from. Have you heard that?
Sure.
Yeah. Now, see, that means to take everything. So if you take all the marbles, you win the game. Okay, you try again. The hang of this.
Well, the microwave is attacking, but the putt pie is winning. Are we starving?
No, we are having fun out here.
Come on, Mom. Play.
Marbles.
Tommy, marbles is a man's game. Girls can't really get the hang of it.
Oh, did you just make a serious mistake?
Is that a challenge?
You are looking at the winner of the Women's Day Award for Creative Mothering. I can play anything.
She can.
Well, hello then, Miss I Won the Award for Mother of the Year. Have you got a shooter?
Where's the topaz?
The yellow one? Dick.
Them spatting words, honey. You never make fun of a person's shooter. Now watch carefully how I do this.
Yeah, we're watching. Now, that's not bad. That's pretty good.
What's this?
Okay, but you got to put some English on it. Let me check. Oh, see how you do it. Huh.
How are you doing?
What are you doing here? Oh, my God!
Tonight, it's Wedding Mania when Urkel stands in as best man for groom guest star Tom Poston on an all-new Family Matters. Then, Eric wants to go to Europe, but he must move up to a B average to get there. Will he pay more attention to his grades or his hot-looking tutor? Find out on an all-new Boy Meets World. Tonight, here on ABC.